you for coming to my retirement party.
Oh, good. Yeah.
As soon as I heard the idea of having a retirement party, I thought, what a great opportunity to play music. because I'm a member of four different ensembles in Lincoln, and some element of all four of them will be here tonight doing some of our repertoire. And first up, Release Time, which is the Nebraska Wesleyan Faculty Staff Band. And over the years, I think 14 or 15 people have been in Release Time for some amount of time. But tonight we have Larry McLean on guitar. Mary Hawk. Candy Hawk. Candy Snowell. My sister-in-law, Jody Stanfield. Yay! And special guests, Richard Barber on keyboard. Yay! And John Gessert on drums. And the first song is an old Todd Rundgren song, which was one of our songs back. So I'd like to dedicate it to my wife, Barb, who's right over there. This was one of our songs back around 1974. And here we go.
Oh,
going to do one more release time song, and then reconvene as Prairie Psycho. Yeah, coming right up.
This next song is a Scott Stanfield original.
And it's called Water on the Rock. Includes a number of references to famous people, some of whom you might recognize. Psycho. Prairie Psycho's first gig in 1997, right here. Except it was around the corner then, but it was in MoJava. And so Prairie Psycho and MoJava go way back. And so I'd like to introduce my bandmate Sam Segrist, Steve Wills, John Gesser. And thanks to MoJava for having us so many times. And I believe there is there's a tip jar. There's a tip jar over there, and I want to see it full by the end of the night. I want to see it overflowing. This song is called Satan is Boring.
The Birdsong heads in the house. All right.
Why do I owe you like a fragment of the moon? So choose to lose another impairment. So so smooth, so smooth. Getting behind, not knowing what's going on, which
story
happens to me. man denied of connectivity. Don't ask me what's on Apple Plus or what's on Amazon Prime. Please don't ask me what's on HBO, 'cause I don't know! We have a short song with a long title, The Trial and Execution of Alice Bluegown, and it's about the possibility that homophobia could be used to impose fascism, which couldn't possibly happen, thank goodness. No. Don't y'all think it's a vulgar message? Yeah.
We didn't really work out.
It's gonna be great.
It'll work out.
So, I first saw Prairie Psycho at the Student Center in 2004. I just transferred Wesleyan. I was in his class, and I heard he was in a band. I went and saw him. They were so good. They played this song, and I loved it. Then I became a fan, and I started recording their live shows. Then I recorded one of their albums, and one of their guitarists moved to Boston. They asked me to join the band, so it's a dream come true to get to play this song that first made me a fan of Prairie Psycho. That's my vulgar message.
Richard, Richard is from Floating Opera, who we're going to hear from shortly. He's going to join us for a short song called The Kids Are Still All Right, which I believe is in the key of D. Okay. Always something to worry about, lots of reasons to fret. I don't have to tell you all how crazy things can get. Stop by pants, suits, shirts, underwear and socks. Stop by everything you can, society is on the rock. But still the sun is going to rise, however long the night. Earth is still a ball of blue and the kids are still alright. Kids are still alright, oh yeah, the kids are still alright. Earth is still a ball of blue and the kids are still alright. Always something to worry about, so down we all must hunker. Plenty of time for a tic-tac-toe when we scratch down in the bunker. Bring along some student aid, and a couple of baseball bats. Feral dogs and cats. But still the sun is gonna rise, however long the night. Earth is still a ball of blue and the kids are still alright. Kids are still alright, oh yeah, kids are still alright. Earth is still a ball of blue and the kids are still alright. He said, welcome to my underground museum. Please keep both of your hands where I can see them. Thank you. Sweet, the drought of March has pierced. Let Zephyrus, with his sweet breath, inspire the tender crops. Cause still the sun is gonna rise, however long the night. Earth is still above you, and the kids are still alright. Kids are still alright, oh yeah, kids are still alright. Earth is still above. Opera.
Yay!
floating opera at full strength is 9 people. And so we don't have the vocalist or the other guitarist or the bassist or the violin or the cello. But we do have Richard. Richard, floating opera is the brainchild of Richard Grabarber right over here. John and I are actually in floating opera as well. And I don't usually sing this, but it was written by Richard and Charles Laurent, basically, and it's called Arbus.
A picture of her so nervous. Shakes on the page. Sleeping with a child half her age. It's part of a strange life that falls and skips. Falls and skips on the truth. Is that a problem? Is that a rhythm in the sun? Is that a problem? Thank you.
Church from Barb. Oh no, we're gonna, after this one more, we have Words from Barb, and then the Star City from Havana.
Woo! It's a complicated procedure.
Yes. We're gonna, this is a Prairie Psycho song written and sung by Steve Wells.
Yeah, the song is called Is That All, Stephen? Is that all? Is that all you got? Thank you.
Seat. You might not know that Scott and I met, it was my freshman year, his sophomore year, in an English class. Aww. And Scott, I got the A, and he got the A minus. Intro to Modern Lit. And I think he didn't get an A because he wouldn't speak in class. He was very shy at that time in his life. And, you know, he has found his voice. And as you all know, he's become a phenomenal professor. And he's had an impact on so many lives. It's really touching to me to see the student, people who were his students, have become his dear friends over time. So, and he's always been the best, most wonderful partner, husband, father, brother, grandfather, and you know, I got really lucky when I was 17 and I met Scott. Aww. So I just want to thank you all, and I just wanted to also thank TJ Hudson, who has encouraged me so much to host this party and bring this together, and he's offered me a lot of support through this process, and I wanted to ask TJ to say a few words.
Come on up with me, Jason. Hey.
Sorry, man. I'm TJ Hudson. Class of mine,
95.
I should have graduated in 93, but I kept taking classes with this guy and a guy named Bill Clefcorn because I had the opportunity to. The three of us are classmates, class of 95, and we went to school of Mary Smith, Ann Satterfield, Bill Clefcorn, Rick Seifert, Scott Stanfield, Roger Cunard, and then we had some brand new instructor course trees. You were just on board. At any rate, we had an amazing experience. I remember, I couldn't quite conceptualize it, but I knew that what I was experiencing was significant, right? And we had a great lineup. At any rate, a few years passed, and Scott and I started hanging out, and I noticed that the English department didn't have a scholarship dedicated to the English department, so it was kind of underserved. So we started something called the Hudson Scholar Award, and for the last two decades, my wife and I have funded that for a deserving English major. As a way to, give back to the university and the experience, but really to kind of
commemorate our experience with those great instructors and my relationship with Scott. So the bad news is the Hudson Scholarship upon your retirement is no more. We're done funding it. But the good news is Jason, Dan, Eric Campbell, myself, and Mary Hickman, wherever she is going to be serving as our link to the, yeah, our liaison, and we're going to be changing that to the Stanfield Award. So, Scott, hey, I'm grateful for your friendship, your mentorship all these years, and it couldn't have happened to a better guy, so, yeah.
Ensemble here in Lincoln. The Star City KOCHAVIM, which plays for services at the South Street Temple. And this ensemble was started by Steve Kalp and Nathaniel Kalp some years ago. Steve is also a faculty colleague at Nebraska Wesleyan, and they're both alums. Jean hasn't left yet. She may have wisely stepped out, but I think she did all right. But this is a small sample of what we sometimes get up to at the South Street Temple.
Oh, look at it. Oh, from Atlanta to getting ready, this song is one of Barb's favorite songs.
She did ask us to do
a set or something like that, she always comes and asks that we sing this.
Yes, because I love it. It's
called Erev, Shel, Shonahim. It's an Israeli song. And it's an Israeli love song that was popularized in the 1950s. Performed by the But the group that made it really famous was the Dudaim brothers, and so we sort of stolen some of what they've done. We're going to be singing in Hebrew though, so to help you have a little idea of what the song is about, I'll just read the English translation for you. Song Erev Shel Shoshanim, evening of roses, let us go out to the grove. Myrrh, perfumes, and frankincense is the carpet under your feet. Night falls slowly and a wind of rose blows. Let me whisper a song for you slowly, a song of love. Dawn and the dove coos, your hair is full of dewdrops. Your lips are as roses until the morning. I will pick them for myself. It is just so shining. It's there.
First wanted us to play, and I think it's just because we thought everyone would know it.
actually more. We're going to take a little breather. Shorter. and the Brothers Karamazov. It's based on one particular plot line involving Dmitri Karamazov and Katerina.
Was that awful rogue catcher, Dmitri?
Yeah, he's an awful rogue.
Yeah.
So, we're joined by Richard on a floating opera. You probably saw him over there. And here's Katerina and Dmitri. One, two. Katerina was her father's pride, but he embezzled on the side, left her mortified and close to ruin. Dmitri said he had the cash, but he made an offer brash, a thing no decent girl would think of doing. Still she came right to his door, but when he didn't ask for more, she knelt down on the floor, said she loved him. She really, really loved him, even though he'd been a cad, even though he treated her so bad. Rich enough to live in Paris, too rich to embarrass, or so you think. But Dmitri pocketed three of her grand, blew it all on a one-night stand with Elkrushenka, her with the cheeks so pink. Just a tart, even though she'll only break his heart. He really, really loves her, loves her hard and loves her strong, even though she does it wrong. And that's the whole of this song. Oh, poor Katerina, what will she do? Well, she will to Ivan, Alyosha too, maybe she will catch a break. How much of this can one girl take? So long, and that's the whole of this song. Babylon. I'm sure you've all read the opening canto of Pound's Cantos. Well, then let me tell you about it. It's a sort of redoing of the scene in Book 12 of the Odyssey where Odysseus visits the land of the dead, and he needs some advice. He's from the dead, so he has to sacrifice a bull in order for the ghost to speak to him. And so this is sometimes read as you have to make a sacrifice sometimes to make the past speak. The past has something important to tell you, but you have to be willing to make a sacrifice, you know, give it ear. Maybe lose a little time that you might have spent playing a video game. So I thought this was kind of a metaphor for teaching, so this song was sort of inspired by teaching, kind of filtered through this canto one of the cantos. There's a tongue in every head. There's a life in every scene. As you walk in the land of the dead, take a little time to breathe. And when you do, you'll gather those. They will speak their truths to you. Cut your ear to hear what they will say.
Of the evening, and
So I first met Scott. Jerise and I came up, we moved to Lincoln almost exactly 30 years ago. And I met Scott not too long afterwards. And we both had a passion for music. And it didn't take us long to start playing music together. And we've had a long and productive and fulfilling relationship playing music together. But he's not retiring from playing music, he's retiring from being an So I guess I'd like to go back to what TJ and Jason and Dan were saying earlier about Scott's legacy as a professor. And has his junior colleague, kind of younger brother, you know, Scott set a bar for teaching that I'll admit, now that I'm retired, I never met. I don't know that I've known any other teacher who's as patient with students as you are. Not that you're as patient with colleagues, but with students, you are endlessly patient and generous. You know, I've sat in on classes you've taught, and students have said things that I would have thought, okay, you're going out into the hall until you think about what you just said. But you would do your Stanfield, well, I guess that's one way to look at it. So I have to say, there is a cult of Stanfield among students and faculty, and it's deserved.
Here, here. Yes.
And now I'll sing a raucous punk song.
Thank you.
This is a song I wrote that was performed both by Prairie Psycho and by Release Time. So now we have the amazing blended band. Also, I also played it in The True Wheel with Richard and his daughter Sonia. So this is my hit. And it is called, I don't want to hit anybody.
We'll get out of your way, sir. You're the honor.
Here we go. Got clearance here? But I want you right on the mic, Patty.
Okay. All right, so.
Do you need to move the mic?
I'm the one to take the beating.
And here I am. So On the fifth anniversary of my surgery, which was last month, I decided to commemorate that with a song about feeling grateful and lucky and happy that I made it after this kind of something that could have been really bad. And it's called Lucky So Far. Slope of the boom. Once in a while I had to learn the hard way what and what not to assume. Crossed a tent to me, but it did not get the best of me. Still through my education, despite being rather reserved, found my way to a special someone better than I probably deserved. Made it through that, crossed the company, still got almost all of the rest of me. Soul, which is also the title of an old hymn, but it's just the same title. It's a different song. And it starts in the key of C. Thank you. Righteous indignation comes easily to me. I fume and I sputter at the news on TV. All things considered, I've little to say. My present circumstances are better than okay. For my heart, it is full. There is peace in my mind. to ventilate my spleen. And those who know me well can tell you that I can be mean. But all things considered, I'm young. I may be a cliche, but I am generally content. For here next week.